cup at Scott. They're all the same on the stream. So if you get Scott, we're not for
right. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. This is Jenks here, live from Dublin. We've got a pot of 37,400 to play for tonight. George has a 2-start to 25. So should be an uphill struggle for Simo to start off with, but he's got to try and get that lead back ASAP. Now, today, obviously, we're going to make it a bit more child-friendly for you. So we've got George Teletubby Tierney against Jamie Sesame Street Simmons. So Satnav won the lag. That's a good break from Jamie, but he's dry. He can't afford to have too many dry breaks today, so I've played George in practice earlier and he was missing absolutely nothing. Cueing the ball really well. So George just having a look at what his first colour's going to be. I mean, he would like yellows, ideally. Oh, it's much, much better lay. I think it will take the middle of these three yellows, just by the black spot, into the bottom left corner.
If you could all share this far and wide, that would be amazing.
Joined by Jakob, of course, the guy behind the best stream in the business. And we have George on yellows. I'll be honest with you, the way George has been queuing, to be fair, I don't really see any mistakes here. Fairly straightforward clearance for him. Looks very focused in his Kevin Moyles orange top. He's obviously taken a leaf out of Moyles' book. He's just got to learn how to have a few more million in his bank account.
Mr. Gill, if you go on YouTube, you should be able to search up Elite Eight Ball TV and you will find it there. I will be probably with you all in a minute. I'm just sorting out a few technical things.
So if we just have a look at the overhead cam, it'll give you a better perspective of what George is dealing with. Very quiet in here today. A few people here watching, not too many at the moment. But I think the crowd will start to come in a bit later towards the business end of the match. George's just going to pop this into the bottom right here and run down for the one on the cushion. Leaves himself a decent enough angle. Just sort of get mid-table for the other yellow. And all barring an earthquake, I think Jamie should be looking 3-0 in the face here. Very focused, George. Almost the new George. No smoking, no drinking. I don't think he's even been anywhere near Fraggle Rock either.
George has come quite far there.
That is not ideal for George, especially bridging over this bit of awkward queuing over this red. Not ideal.
He's got a bit of a cut into the middle.
Yeah, I think that's all he's got. He has to mind the white here, where the white's going. He looks a bit disgusted with that shot, really. Looks like a great shot from George. That is a great shot. 3-0 to George.
And that is 3-0. Nice little clearance from George.
Well, you know you're playing well when you haven't missed a pot all match. Jamie Simmons has got to watch this break today if he keeps going dry. I mean, he's going to get punished for it without a doubt. George has been making between 2 and 4 balls off every break today. He likes to set up his own, which will obviously be overseen by the ref. Make sure it's not twisted or... push forward in any way.
Today's game is being ref by Desi Burke.
Desi Burke. Sounds like he should play for Reg's team. I still think I was right, you know, with the Reg's team. They should be called the Desi Rascals.
I think that's perfect. Absolutely perfect.
Right. Second frame in. George to break. Yeah, it's a nice break. Basically, one problem red, one problem yellow. Now, I mean, totally, wouldn't be surprised if George took reds here. I just wonder whether he has got any of that angle. Can we have a look at the overhead cam again?
Sure. So I've just put the link up for the YouTube for those of you who are looking.
Yeah, he's gonna drop this in, get an angle to come into that red, that awkward red that's by the cushion with the yellow. This comes out, and it's come out absolutely beautiful. George will be happy with that. Well, Michael Richards, it's I mean, at the end of the day, Simo offered him the start, and you know, if anyone offers you a start, you're going to take it. There's no way George asked for it, so you know, it is what it is. So again, Jamie just sat in his seat watching on. keep rolling them in. Obviously, the slight awkward one is the one he has just above the yellow, above the middle bag. But, I mean, even that isn't difficult to get on. He's just got to mind his work. No silly mistakes. And stun up for the red in the middle. What's he done there? He just got nothing out of that white ball whatsoever. He wanted to stun up, be almost straight for the red into the middle, and then he's just got a diagonal red into the right corner, and for the either I'll be tempted to screw into them or just round the back of this yellow would be nice.
Come on, Jamie.
Well, he's not on it. It's I don't think it's a turtle from there. Jamie stood up. He was quick out of his seat there. I do apologise. I have to speak so quietly because it is so quiet in here. Well, Jamie Simmons gets his first bite at the cherry. I would say if he's got any sense, you have to get this frame. You have to play the snooker, push the red in front of the black, yellow in front of the black. Play the percentages, play percentage shots. That's the shot. Make the game safe. Has to make the game his from here. Also, the way he's played it as well makes a. Pretty much a skill shot on the black, virtually, well, impossible. And we'll see another snooker here. So. Believe it or not, we're seeing a safety game from Simo. Or are we? He's Jamie, he's probably looking at a finish from here, but I think the percentage shot is still the shot. He doesn't like it though. He's a bit So I'm just going to get this music turned down just a touch. He still might be okay. Jamie played the right way in that frame there, so does George made that mistake. You know, it's pointless going gung-ho and trying to take out a ridiculous finish when there was no need. There's no rush. So, 3-1 Jamie, back to Jamie's break. Still only the third frame in, of course, because George had a two-frame start. Just while the ref's setting up, we'll have a shout out to Jarrow MOT Centre and the Shark Wreck, who are two of Jakob's very kind sponsors. Yeah, we're seeing a different Jamie Simmons tonight. He wants to claw that start back ASAP. Nothing stupid. Leafy ball's on the table. The likes of Mikkel will always tell you things like that, because Mikkel won't pot one ball unless he sees a finish. Jamie Simmons on the Red Bull after a few beers, a little sleep this afternoon. Curled up like a little mouse he was. Oh, now he's he's swig of Red Bull, swig of Budweiser. Amazing. Just pushed his red up to the top of the table here. Now, if we're going to get involved in a safety game, Jamie's just got to mind himself here that he doesn't get caught out with getting a snooker laid in behind those reds up there at any point. But he's decided to lay a snooker himself. This is definitely a new Jamie Simmons that I've seen. not taking anything for granted. He's not doing anything silly. Looks like he's been in training by Keith Brewer, the way he's playing. Jamie Simmons has actually played three safety shots in a row. Not too sure whether the world's going to end tomorrow or something, but I've never seen anything like it. Can't be the way he likes playing, surely. But he's got to do what he's got to do to win the money at the end of the day. Mickey Mullins, hello sir, how are you? After our little late night conversation at 4 o'clock in the morning the other night, whilst I was on the ferry. Can't exactly tell you what the conversation was about, but it was a fair effort from Jamie, so he was unlucky there, but I mean, almost knowing with the red down here by these two yellows, he wasn't going to leave an easy finish for George. Aaron Wells, how are you, sir? I mean, what's he done there? I'm almost adamant he was meant to hide the red behind, hide the white behind the red there. Now, this is where Jamie starts to go to work. He wasn't going to turn this clearance, down by any stretch. But he still has to make sure.
Terry Matchett, no, I will also be on commentary. I'm just doing a few things behind the scenes at the moment.
Well, Jamie, was fed off George's mistake there. He's thinking, if you're going to keep playing shots like that, I'll dish him up. So, 3-2 to George. Little smile there from Jamie. Mr. Galloway in the background, of course, giving it a bit. Just don't think there's any chance of his good lady Pam Mooney quieting him down tonight. Well, not this time of night, anyway. So, George just set up his rack again. Michael Folan's joined us. Gilway's number one. One of my biggest fans a few weeks ago. So, he's made a ball. An absolute horror split. I think first shot here little plant, knock the red in the middle. Obviously at Black Ball Rules, this is an open table still, so he can play any combination of shot he likes. I can say, hit it with a bit of pace and hopefully that yellow would come round and actually move that red, but he was unlucky not to. So George on reds. Now, if George could just take the one to the top left-hand corner here and make either some sort of dislodge. I don't think it goes, doesn't go to the middle past the black. So he's just going to just try and dislodge this here. So he just dislodges this. He really has got three drop-ins. So he's going to have to come back down the table. That's awkward for George. The only thing that can save George a bit here is if he can top this red right through and get the white as high at the table as he possibly can, just so he can possibly just drop the one in the corner bag with hardly any pace whatsoever, so he can take the red to the other corner. I mean, if he gets on it too well, he could get on the plant, but I don't think that be the shot of choice. He hasn't hit that anywhere near hard enough, really. I mean, you're looking at another foot minimum to make this shot nice. He's struggling to hold for the other red. I just wonder whether he'll try and flick off the red that's by the cushion and pop the other one. Oh no, he's going to try and move it. That's a great shot. Nicely controlled shot from George there. He just had enough to play that shot. So George restores his two-frame lead.
Stop that! Hit the wall! Yeah.
George has got a bit of a following here. A few more people starting to come in and watch. Mr. Duff has just turned up. In his white shirt. Not my cup of tea, of course. Thank you, Michael Folan. I know you're only messing, mate. I got the gist of you by now. I'll abuse you later on Facebook. Be fine.
So, I'm now joining. Good evening, people. Hope you're enjoying the match so far.
Welcome, Jakob.
Cheers, Jenksy. So, somebody saying that destroy mode has already been employed. Well, we'll have to see, won't we?
Yeah.
He's been practicing quite a lot, so you never know.
I think we're gonna see a decent standard of Paul here tonight.
Yeah, I think so too.
That's a decent first shot from Simo, that is. That has opened him up like a can of beans. So, just need to watch the white here where he drops this in. Again, if we can just drop this in the right centre and get nicely on his next ball, I don't see anything but a finish here.
Hi, Lewis Healing. Thank you very much, Dave McCrory. Spot on, mate. We aim to please.
Oh, come on, George.
Jamie's missed that. George back at the table.
Gavin Cleary. Yeah, this should be a fairly close match. Both good players. Robert McKenna, it says at the top of the screen what they're playing for, £37,400.
So George has got a bit of a dilemma here, especially with the black. He's going to have to try and get rid of this yellow using a combination shot at some point. It doesn't seem too phased. He's queued up nicely. Now, here's the shot if he's got the angle. Yeah, he's looking at screwing this in and getting the white full in the face onto that black. Potting the yellow.
Ryan Collins, I hope you're taking the mickey, as that's also at the top of the page.
Missed cannon, and he won't be happy with that because that wasn't the most difficult of shots.
He's now going to have to do a sat-nav and reroute a little bit.
Yes, George is wearing tracksuit bottoms and black shoes. He's gone for the shameless look. But he is mixing it up with the Moorsy look, so, you know.
Yeah, I think Kevin Moore's going to be a little bit upset about that.
Yeah, the bottom half is, you know, definitely, you know, a bit pikey. But and the top half, excluding his head, is, you know, Roy Moores-ish. Orange is the new black.
It's sort of a cross between Snatch, Kevin Moyles, and an officer and a gentleman with a haircut.
Yeah, he had a little sharp haircut down. I said to him, Jesus, you got into the Marines or something with his sharp looking hairdo. So, mistake really from George, you've got to say. That wasn't the hardest of cannons to make, to either smash into that black and pop that yellow or get the black out. George not looking very happy with himself about that.
Jamie's got a very valuable effort to be able to clear these now. This shouldn't be a drama.
I'm just wondering, I don't think he needs to, but I was going to say play the plant. Now, I'm not quite sure why he's played it like that.
No.
He was absolutely dead straight on that where he was. And you'd have almost been inclined just to actually play the yellow off the black onto the yellow, just to get the black off the cushion a little bit, but not that he really needed to with his lower board, because he could have still got back for the black.
That, unfortunately, was probably the best he could have done.
I think he's fell into George's hands a little bit here. Yes, George had a two start. Now, George just having a look. As to his route of safety play. I mean, this should not be ever an issue for Jamie to hit these. Very, very natural, easy shot for a snooker player. But you say
he's
that, and he misses it by almost 5 or 6 inches.
That's pretty much what his missus said.
I've got a scoreboard.
So the ref just moves the white for George.
I actually personally thought that he would have been better off coming off just one cushion near the middle pocket with a little bit of side.
Yeah, but I mean,
Jamie should never miss that shot. I mean, plays it another 10 times, he gets them every one.
This is true.
It's not often I lie.
Exactly, Callum, yeah. Well, Galloway just shouts out, good shot, George.
Gallows like his little wind-up merchant.
So, not too sure, we're only four frames in, and Gallo's getting a bit vocal already, bless him. You still expect George to go for these and get on them. It's not ideal. I mean, the red at the top of the table. He could ideally be with unless he moves these with this red and pots. There you go, that's opened up.
That's a good shot from George.
Yeah.
He doesn't make many mistakes from these situations, to be fair.
Simon Gibson. Actually, Galloway's spent quite a bit of time with George over the years, with Satnav over the years, sorry. And so indeed of George, they're actually friends.
So George's just got to be careful here. As long as it doesn't go in the middle, that's a great shot.
Wow.
Well.
Jamie's got to be counting his blessings now.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, George had the frame at his mercy there. What's he playing here?
Just like to see, he's still got to mind his work. I wouldn't start shouting yet, people, because he's more than capable of potting this. Wow. What a mistake from these two in this frame. I mean, that is sacrilegious. That is, wow. But George, tight on the cushion. He's got to cue this well.
Missed it by a mile.
I'll tell you what, these boys are getting more chances than Henry VIII has on a Friday night. Yeah. Or did on a Friday night.
Wow.
Yeah, Martin Latimer, I also think that he shouldn't have bothered moving the black.
There was no need.
With that kind of skill level, he should really have just taken the outside yellow.
But not only that, Jakob, if you remember where the black was and where George's red was,
yep.
You know when he'd made the mistake with the queuing, he could have dropped a snooker in there, left the ball right over the pocket, do you know what I mean?
Yep, definitely.
You know, but he couldn't do that with where he'd moved the black away, so...
Tell you what, I take it as a compliment.
I'll tell you what, he's got away with murder there.
I'll tell you what, I take it as a compliment that there's people in the room that are watching the stream.
Unbelievable.
That's a nice touch.
Wow.
No, he's not left it particularly easy.
Yeah, Mickey Mullins, this is your sort of standard game, I think, mate. Well, what about this big pocket up here with the yellow? What about a reverse double? Or is he going for a clean cut?
That's a great shot from George.
Awesome shot.
Tell you what, you could almost think he really has been practicing, couldn't you?
Yeah. No, it's a great pop.
Five, two.
George just looks over at his looks over towards Gallo, just gives him a look of, did you just see that? Don't ever back against me again, was that look. Absolutely bang on.
So we've got a special guest listening in. Elizabeth Killeen plays for Ireland, ladies. Oh, sorry, on the IPA tour, rather. Not for Ireland just yet. That's yet to come.
We picked her up off the street yesterday. She's she was sat in the street looking homeless with a cue in her hand.
So we took her into this dodgy place called Terry Rogers.
Yeah. Showed her sort of loosely how to play pool. And
then she kicked our asses.
Yeah. And she's back today.
Turns out she's actually better at doubling than just putting a ball straight.
Well, she is from Dublin.
That's terrible.
Well, it is what it is. So then, George to break. Looking very sexy with his navy seal hairdo. That's a good break from George. I think
evening, Simon Crawford.
Definitely be looking at yellows here. That's not an awkward start. I mean, he's got such an easy starter on reds. But yeah, I think he has to try and take these yellows here. But what do I know? He'll probably. Choose something different. Let's get rid of this yellow to the left middle. No Simon Crawford, I'm not betting tonight. I'm a very poor man at the moment. As I say, you know, come over to Dublin, we do our charity work, you know. I've had to rehouse Liz, you know. You know, it's cost me a fortune. It's quite funny, actually. She says she's got the headphones on, but she can't answer or reply, so I can get away with basically anything I'd like. So back to the pool and less about the charity work that I've been doing.
So the yellow into the middle still goes, and there is a plant if he manipulates.
There is a plant. He needs to be really quite low on it, though, because it is actually fairly thin, because the yellow is so close.
So this is a tough shot. I think from George's perspective, maybe there should be a safety in behind these two yellows.
Yeah, we'll just have a look on the overhead cam for a minute. Yeah, he's going to play a safety shot. That is a poor safety shot, really.
Yeah, he's left Jamie with a shot on this middle yellow. Middle red, sorry.
I think I mean, it depends how his cueing is. He needs to hide the white right at the top, right that, by that top right corner bag. Would be ideal. But as long as he covers these two yellows, yeah, he's covered all three by the looks of it. It's a good shot. It's probably a bit much asking him actually to get the white up to the top right hand corner. But George can see this. Look at him, fine figure of a man, stood there like a machine. Yeah, look at him, like a stallion. Or is it a Hereford bull? I can't remember. Well, so, one problem ball for Simo, which is the one behind the black.
He'll be looking to get this out a little bit early.
But he, yeah, obviously, but you still have to be careful.
Or is he potentially going to take the bag?
I think he's just going to
Not take the bag.
I think he'll mess it up completely.
Sounds unlucky to me.
And try and cover the cushion with the red.
At least nothing goes down the rail now. I tell you.
Right, well,
that's an opportunity handed away there, isn't it?
Because he can just drop the red down the rail when he's got the red in the other corner. He's left his routes open for him.
This shouldn't even be a hard clearance now.
He's absolutely perfect on that. Just screw back right onto the cushion. Ideally, it needs to be absolutely dead straight on it. Because
turns out that Matty Hawkins isn't quite as deluded as we thought. He knows he's good at putting balls on the cushions.
There you go, you see. Just another look from the overhead cam. Again, it's a safety shot, but it's not perfect. I'd like to have snookered him. Well, I think opportunity can see it.
If he can, it's definitely very little.
the good thing about it is the white is going, if he comes off this yellow, at least the white's going in the right direction for Simo, somewhere up the anywhere up the table, because he can obviously get to these reds that pop past the black.
That was very close.
It was very close, and Sim almost left himself open for that, to for George to get lucky off of getting out of the snooker.
I think that's also sat so closely to the black that there's not really a safety to be played.
Yeah, it's not nice. So all of a sudden, it's...
Alan Green, I agree. You wouldn't have turned down that finish.
All of a sudden, has that made George favourite for this frame? Depends how much of this red he can see. And he doesn't like it. Tell you what, Jakob, I wish we had a zoom on this overhead cam. That might be something to look at in the future. Because that would be nice to zoom in on that shot, seeing how much of this red he can see.
You don't want much, do you, bud?
Not really. Doesn't like. That's a good shot. It's a great shot. He's used the double kiss to lay the snooker there. Very clever shot from Simo. George doesn't look happy.
That's because he forgot to change his jogging bottoms.
Well, he looks like he's turned up. Almost like turned up in his pants like he did at school when you forgot your PE kit and he's rumbled through the lost property box.
And Jamie's wearing shorts.
Not even just September, but it's actually nearly October and Jamie's wearing shorts. And it's not really that warm in here.
And
he's in Ireland.
So a bit tip tap. I see a lot of people asking if this is like world rules, but it just goes to show in black ball rules you get these safety exchanges as well. I mean, I know a lot of you boys slag off the world rules for plenty of safety play, but it just goes to show that it does happen in these rules, especially when you got two clowns like these playing. Jamie Simmons probably edging it on looks. Probably George definitely edging it on white.
That's a great shot.
But love them both dearly. And there goes Gallo again. That's the difference. I don't wear tight t-shirts, Kieran. I wouldn't want to embarrass you with my body.
T-shirts just become tight on him.
Yeah. I wear tents now these days.
That is potentially a very, very good shot.
Well,
that's a couple of good shots from George now.
Well, if he can get this to the middle, and he's got to cue it like a dream and get the white back across to the yellow in the bottom left. Should be all over. We've got Pam Mooney in the house. David Galloway's lovely lady. Sat there looking like something out of Dynasty. So George having a good think about this. I think he's just got to play this full-blooded into the middle bag.
Oh no. Depends where he's going. He's got to be full-blooded whatever he plays. Can't tell what he is playing.
Oh, George. I don't think that was a shot. I didn't like that shot.
Well, it hit the cushion not even that far past the middle pocket.
Mind you, if they were if it's a table from Murphy's, it would probably still gone.
I don't know. Another 3 inches down or maybe.
Oh, I'd love another 3 inches. Probably make it up to 4.5 then. So
easy little clearance here.
Yeah, so
5-3
indeed to George. I'll be honest with you folks, I'm going for a cigarette because it's not enthralling me that much at the moment, but I feel a little cigarette break coming on because Jamie's just gone for a comfort break to the toilet. We'll be back shortly.
So, 5-3, Jamie Simmons to break. Let's see. Quick sip of the beer, should help. Draw again. A very nice split though, unfortunately for Jamie. There's if George can see an easy yellow, which the plant's on down the bottom pocket. Otherwise he's going to have to get the black out somehow on reds. He's opted for the plant and he's missed. Jamie would be very happy with that. Makes up for the dry break. There was a 2-start given to George. Jamie offered it, I think, so that he could get the game on, because he's been hankering after this game for a very long time. Where's that white gone? Ouch. That's going to be painful. Jamie Satnav has directed him straight into the sea there. Steve Lawson, Galloway's actually on Jamie's side, having backed him, I think, 10 grand or somewhere around there. If they did manage to get the whole 10 grand on, then that would be the biggest single bet on pool so far in the UK. Neither of these boys really showing their calibre at the moment. Indeed, rerouting. George opting straight away for a bit of safety play. Daz Cheatham, that was meant to be the biggest bet by one person. Claimed by Galloway last night anyway. He said there's been some big bets, but none as big as that. Tippy-tappy play so far in this match, in this frame. Greg Boner, we've been asked to stream this match. Not the Sheppy match. That's a nice little shot there from Jamie. Shot back there from George, at least stopping the yellow from being able to go. Not sure whether any of the reds go into this middle pocket. Doesn't look like they do. Black well and truly covered from the bottom pocket now. I think it possibly could have snuck in past the yellow until that shot. Fair enough, Daz Cheatham. I stand corrected. I was only going by information that I'd been given from someone else. And that is a foul. Shot and a visit. Jamie now has an option to get this yellow out. If he feels confident in the rest of the balls. And he wants to take the white. The ref called it because he was watching quite closely. Those yellows have not landed friendly for Jamie. Yeah, this is at the Terry Rogers Club, also known as the Fairview Snooker Club in Dublin. So Jenks has just returned to us. Jamie's just had a shot and a visit. He's opened up the pocket, potting one of his balls, but he's unfortunately landed back in trouble.
Okay, well, he's found the snooker. Nothing. If it is a total snooker, it certainly isn't a drama for George to get out of it.
He's calling for the ref's opinion. So it must be very close.
Anyway, what was the comment earlier on the stream where the likes were going up like every second and there's about 15
It was about people that sit at home and comment saying that everybody would smash up these two players and so on.
Oh, I see. That old chestnut.
Armchair warriors.
But the game is easy, isn't it, sat here?
Of course.
We all clear the table sat here.
Even I clear up sat here.
Yeah. That is some statement.
Cheers, Terry Rob. And you're very welcome, mate. Took a bit of setting up today. The stream's getting bigger and bigger. Loads more camera angles, etc. So starting to take quite a long time to set up.
We'll just actually...
having a look at Simo's shirt.
So another angle of what Simo's got to go at here. Nice to see a few of you liked my picture on the banter page as well of Jakob in his sleeping bag on the ferry. Sleeping bag gate.
Thank you very much, Gareth Aries.
So, for any of you that are watching, any predictions on what the score is going to be? And more importantly, probably, how long this match is going to take. We could be here a while. So the table was actually running a little bit slow before I got my hands on it earlier before the match. I gave it a good brush, spray with water, rebrushed and then ironed, and it was seemed to be running a treat after that. Jakob levelled it after we had to move it. Certainly don't seem to have any complaints so far.
So we've got Sam Jones, our little mate. He's set up the stream in the pub.
Ah, good boy.
And
what, along with the boxing?
Yeah, along with the boxing. Not a bad shout. Yeah, why don't you all get it on the tellies in your local? Get it far and wide. They've not quite got the weight of the table perfect yet, have they?
That's because I ironed it. I tricked them. It was all just a big trick. I thought I'll catch these boys out.
Did Jamie pay you to do that?
Yep.
So Jamie was saying yesterday that he didn't like the fact that the table was quite slow.
Oh, there you go, you see. It's amazing what £1,000 in me hand can do. Cheers, Jamie. Tell you what, it's a good shot.
That's a frame winner.
Well,
it should be.
He would love here. He would love to pop this and cannon this yellow. Hit this yellow full in the face. And if he does, and he gets on it nice. Well, he's actually got away with that a little bit, I think.
I was going to say, what do you reckon to a little skilly here?
No, he's going to play it inside the red. There's a gap.
Ah.
There is a gap.
Beautiful.
Well, he's got a choice here.
Oh yeah, so there is.
He's got a choice of three shots. He's just lined up another one. Well, I don't like the one off the black. I think he's
no, it's pointless.
He's actually committing pool suicide there.
Yep.
If he tries that.
Oh, at least he's having another look at a different one. Because yeah, I agree with you fully. That is pool suicide.
I think he's got a plant into this red corner.
Sorry, Seb. I was a bit of a distance away from the overhead view, so I couldn't really see where it went.
I did go for this middle. I wondered whether he could get on it, but I thought, no, I better not say it in case everybody just jumps all over me.
What, like Seb just did with me on the skilly? Monkey.
Yeah, it's a good finish, mate, from Simo there.
Not bad at all. Good finish.
Yeah, good finish. 5-4.
5-4. One off that start that he gave George.
He's got to get that back to levels, though. Can you hear Gallo? Wow. Oh, Seb will be watching this with one eye on both of these players. I'm sure he'd like to have a shot at both of them again.
Yeah.
Someone just commented, the refs come dressed as a pool cloth.
Brilliant.
Good work.
Somebody just said, can you shout in English, please?
It was Ray Dean.
Can you shout in English, please?
Yeah.
So, Jamie Simmons break. Let's see what we got, Jamie. Come on. Let's have one where you're not dry. Oh, or is it? No, sorry. It's George to break. I thought it was, but Jamie looked like he was eager to go and smash them up.
George Simmo's just getting ready to feed off his dry break.
Right. Fair enough.
That's all that was.
At least he's eager. Hello, Rob Holt. Good evening, sir.
Ah.
How are we doing?
There he is. I'll tell you what, I've just called this dry break.
Oh, it is a dry break. It's a very dry break and a very open break.
Yes.
Right then.
Here we go.
Let's see what you got, Mr. Simmons. Jamie's. Peter Trotman.
Pete Trotman. What a guy he is.
Gallo's impression of Father Jack's spot on. Indeed.
Anyway, Pete Trotman, when are you going to stop all this nonsense with your missus and the newborn and actually come back and play county? You know, you've got priorities, mate. And we sort of miss you.
Dwayne Murphy, behave yourself, mate. He's saying Jordan Church versus either one of these, who wins? It's like saying...
Oh, I don't know. Jordan Church, I think he's a step above, isn't he?
Exactly, that's what I mean.
Yeah. He's a very naughty boy.
I've seen Jordan Church pull off some rather disgusting finishes.
Somebody is actually called Aaron Banbury, which is where me and Jakob live. That is amazing.
Don't tell him, mate. Come on.
That's not bad from Simo. It's
quality,
not bad at all.
Quality, Rob. Rob Holt wore his Elite TV top two the Southern Tour today.
Did he?
How'd you get on, Rob?
Rob Holt making us famous wherever he goes.
Hope you did well, mate.
Probably went out in the group stage. Oh, he's got...
I'll tell you what, it was a nice little flick, but I actually would have thought that it had screwed back to flick the blackout. He's in a whole heap of trouble now.
Yeah, he's in a spot of bother here.
Playing like this,
off the back cushion in the middle back.
Oh, I'll tell you what... Surely the hand's got to go up for that.
I don't think he did. He just swagged it around the table, saying, have some of that. He didn't care, he fluked it.
We'll ask him later. He probably didn't fluke it, knowing Jamie.
Double in the corner.
He's missed that by a whole barnyard. Sorry, kid. I'll tell you what, playing like this, I don't think either of these would get out of the group stages at the Southern Tour.
Don't you start. There's a lot of money at stake here. Well, he lays a snooker, but again, pushes his ball onto a cushion, which, you know, shot on a visit, means he can't get all his balls out in one go. Now, this is where Jamie Simmons generally does excel, at getting out snookers and working out silly angles.
Do you think that's because he's so used to snookering himself?
Old trick shot boy.
It probably is due to that crazy white and snookering himself so much, isn't it?
Well, yeah.
Hmm.
him and Seb definitely came from the same loins, I think.
He just flicked it. Did you see the white ball heat map that someone put up yesterday? Zach Leonard.
Yeah, yeah. Brilliant. Seb Webb's heat map. That was funny. Well, has he left this or not?
It actually does look like he has, doesn't it?
Looks like he's left it. Where's that overhead cam?
Let's have a look at the overhead.
I reckon he can see an edge of that.
Yep. I think it snicks in.
How's your eyesight, Simo?
Not that good. Whoops. So he can come off eight cushions, but he can't hit a snick of a ball.
He's got. George has still got a problem ball. But you have to say this table is running quite nice. Even the one on the cushion isn't a problem ball as such.
I think Jamie's sat navs needs recalibrating.
Yeah, I do. Gallo gives Simo a high five there. I'm not quite sure what for.
Rob Lumsden's renaming it the Shat Nav. I like it. Currently got 1,200 of you watching. Why don't you give it a share and we'll get it up.
George. What was it played there? Sorry, I didn't mean to talk over you then. I was watching a shot of just disbelief there.
No problem.
I mean, was it me or did George hit that so bad? Did he play that to pot that red and move that yellow? Or was it... Or did he get played to push it safe? I don't know.
I wouldn't really like to hazard a guess, mate.
I'm not quite sure what went through George's head there. You know what it is, don't you? It's the moils in him with that orange top.
Do you think that's what he's gone for?
Yeah. You know, I've told you the only difference between them is probably just a couple of million in the bank. It's the only difference now. In fact, I even think George is better looking.
There's got to be a whole army of Moylesy fans that will disagree with you there.
Oh, wow, it's gone in. What a shot that is. He played for that, to be fair. Oh, wow.
How's he missed that after that?
Now, George just stares at Gallo. George stares at Gallo. Gallo blows him a kiss. Wow. After Gallo giving it loads there, George is just going to rip him for that. Wow.
Good evening, Mary Cunningham.
Mary Cunningham, yes. What a girl. Wasn't sure that she was still alive, actually. She hasn't messaged me for a while.
Evening, Pomerola.
Super Pomerola. Hello, sir.
I think he's going to try and play off the knuckle of the jaw here. Wow!
Can we have an action replay?
Yes, we can.
Can we have an action replay?
Wow. I'm just going to have to get it to the right place for you.
We're going to have a little action replay of this. Are you ready, folks? A little action replay.
2 seconds.
Wow.
Let's have a look.
What a naughty shot.
So.
Wow. Wow.
Off the knuckle, can off the ball.
Can we actually watch it again? Because I even... How is that?
No. I'll give it to you again in a bit.
Wow.
We'll have another little look in a little while.
Right, we're at 5-5, aren't we?
We are at 5-5. That's the start gone.
The start has gone. George looking very red in the face there. Now, George, I'll tell you what, Gallo's very, very vocal.
That.
Very vocal when Simo's at the table. So you can't say there can be any complaints of his vocal when George is either. I'll tell you what, I think he's starting to find a bit of a rhythm, you know, Yak.
He definitely looks like he's got a bit more swagger on his...
Yeah, just a bit of a swaggies.
Bit of jump to his step.
Yeah, swagging around, sort of Larkin-esque. Or Larkin, should I say. So, a couple more people turned up. Another guy in an orange T-shirt.
No, it's Morsey too.
Yeah, it is Morsey too.
Except this guy's a bit more muscly than Morsey.
Yeah, he's like a machine, this guy.
So we've got different chiselled versions of Morsey in the room.
Yeah, I'd say George is a less chiselled.
I was thinking he was a starting coal.
I think he's still on it. Oh,
I tell you what, I don't think he is. Doesn't look like it, does it? Nope.
Can he turn it in? I think he can. There you go.
Yes, he can. And that looks very much like
he gets himself in the lead.
Jamie Simmons in the lead.
He won't miss this back to the middle.
No, he won't.
And the lead is gone.
That is going to hurt. That's going to hurt. George's face has gone a little bit crimson, mate.
All of a sudden, first time in the lead. So,
in the background,
now it's James' turn to break. He may have a break now.
No, it's George's. You are wrong.
What was I watching?
I'm not sure. Probably Dynasty.
I've been concentrating too much on Gallo, actually. No, definitely wasn't looking at Dynasty. So, should we have a look? The break from the overhead cam.
Well, actually, if you wait, we'll have a little look at. We'll have a little go on this look. Hold on. It was a 2-start. Thank you very much, Callum Singleton.
Yeah, and Mary.
We do our best.
Nice comments as always. Mind you, I'm not too sure I should be particularly nice to Callum. After meeting him in the Leicester tour. Yeah, sorry, Sean Daly, that was my fault. George makes a ball then, makes a red. And, well, he's got no immediate angle to get into these two yellows. He could take reds.
Good, reds are actually quite nice.
If he drops the red in the bottom right and tries to get on the one by the cushion early, he could take a finish out.
He's
on it. That is absolutely perfect.
He's even knocked the black out a little bit.
Yeah.
Nice.
A little bit.
I'd be surprised if this isn't a break dish. Did someone just say, I'm loving the painted on orange shirt?
It does look like one of those painted on ones, to be fair.
Someone also just said, I think the stream puts too much pressure on George. I don't think so. I'm pretty sure George is fairly used to playing on stream by now.
What has George played there?
I mean, he's even got one in his bedroom.
George, what have you done, boy? He's scowling at that. He's got to try and get out of this with the. He's got to try and get out of this either with a double or a thin cut, but he plays a thin cut. The white is wild. He's playing the thin cut.
That was nice to see. Everybody completely quiet while George focused on that shot.
Yeah. No, that's fair.
Even play. Galloway.
Yeah. Which is, amazing in itself. Right. George has got a big shot to pull off here now. He's got to cue this with everything he's got to try and get back to one of these reds. Come on then, George. Show us what you got, boy. Cue it, son. It's almost awkward cueing as well. This is a tough shot. He's on it to the corner in a fashion. Now he's got to play it in the top corner, and he's got to stun it round, I would say, for the red in the opposite middle. That's a great shot.
That is a great shot.
That's a fantastic response from George.
The blushing starting to fade from his face.
Ooh. 100% George. Wow. I had a feeling he'd miss it, you know. I'll tell you what, that was an inch or two just too close to the black to make it a comfortable pot.
Yep, I see what you mean.
And he will be absolutely livid with himself.
Callum Singleton saying class finish. Unfortunately, mate, he didn't quite make that last ball.
Callum Clown Singleton.
So, Jamie getting a free go at these. Taking the plant. Let's have a look what you've got, Jamie. That's a good shot. That's a great shot. George will be kicking himself here. It should have been all over. In fact, it was easy for it all to be over. Jamie now looking very focused. Looking like things are going to change for him. Completely comfortable in the room. Not bothered by the crowd. Nice little use of the knuckle there. Whoops. Still, this shouldn't be a drama. And that's a finish. So, not only has the start gone, but Jamie Simmons is now two in front. Yeah, it was close, Jothan. Very close.
Stop
I just had one of the crowd come and approach me and ask whether it was all right for Galloway to be shouting like he does. Or was it a bit embarrassing for the stream? I said it's standard Galloway. It's unavoidable if he's in the room watching a money match. So David Galloway has asked someone to put one right on Galloway's chin. Interesting. Is this Gallo's split personality showing through? So, just having a break for a minute. Both players going for a small break. Jamie to break, and he's made a ball this time. Let's have a look how they've fallen. Hope you're all enjoying tonight. I think once these players properly settle in, we'll see some good work. Selecting reds. These should almost be a formality. Dean, I'll see what I can do about a little slow motion black into the corner from earlier a little bit later on. Having a little look at where this black's going to go. Got to force the white ball off the top cushion here. Look at slamming into these two yellows to hold with the black in the middle pocket. Off two cushions. No, it's gone the other way. Don't know if that was
a little bit by accident. Given he queued it up for the other side. Nevertheless, that is now Jamie Simmons, 8-5. And George Tierney to break.
Well, if you can hear Gallo on the stream, folks, you'll have to apologise for the swearing. But he has got a lot of money riding on this, so... Hey, but at least it's not a swearing, eh? So, Jamie Simmons starts to stretch his legs. I believe, is that six in a row? Six in a row from 5-2.
I'm pretty sure that is six in a row. I tell you what, when George is warmed up a little bit and his arm's loose, he has got a hell of a break on him, hasn't he?
Yeah, but I'm... I know for a fact, George, once he does start getting behind, he can start getting even worse for him. Once it starts getting in his head.
Yeah.
I mean, even I had that when I played him.
Yeah.
13-8 down, I remember. The next 7. And his head was in bits.
And he's not looking that happy now, is he?
No. Adam Penwell with us?
You know what, the thing is, right, that I was just saying George has got a big break when his arm's loose, but look at where the balls are. Look how close to the cushions so many of the balls are. I think if George took off 25%, he probably would he'd probably have a better joy with it.
Yeah.
And Simo did give George a 2 start in this game.
I think George's arm at the moment is about as loose as his t-shirt.
I don't understand what you mean, mate. George's t-shirt's painted on.
No, he's got no run there.
Daryl Whitworth.
Thank
love
you,
it, mate.
Thank you, Penis.
Ryan McKillop, I'm not sure what you're talking about. Neither of us have been swearing. Maybe the crowd, but there's not really a lot that we can do about that.
Yeah, we haven't sworn once, Ryan. So it's the people in the crowd, unfortunately, which we really can't do much about.
No, Niall McCarthy, we're not streaming the Folan v McCarthy match. Galloway's got some money on Jamie Simmons.
Of course, because he's not backing George at all anymore.
I think he's actually just trying to get money back off George.
I don't think it's just coin either. I think it's a lot of paper stuff, and a lot of it. I agree, Brendan, but we try and just keep everything right from now on. Thank you, Stuart Adamson.
Thank you to all of you.
Yeah, just thanks to everybody.
Thanks, man. Thanks. And welcome to our show. The Simo and George Show. With Jenks and Jakob.
Mr. Gill's watching it from the pub. You can't hear the commentary anyway, so obviously he's having a few tonight, Saturday night. Thank you.
So again, we've got involved in a little tactical exchange here. Unlucky and off there.
Galloway's just saying that Jamie needs to stop going on his phone, but he was just texting his mum to say, "I'm really sorry, mum, but I've just gone in off." That is a shot and a visit to George. So apparently Jamie's on Tinder, which we're in Ireland, so I can't blame him.
Yeah, I must admit, I've seen a few women in Ireland this
Wow. Our little friend, Elizabeth, that we picked up off the street yesterday.
Yeah.
She's a beautiful lady.
Yeah. Jakob's particularly fond of her, I think.
I think pretty much everyone in the room is, to be honest.
Yeah, everybody's chancing their arm, to be fair.
Even George asked earlier if she wanted to be her his kid's dad.
Well, he hasn't hit that. So,
how far is that in? No skill shot on that yellow available. Unless, can Jamie see this down to the bottom left-hand corner? Screw into the reds and hopefully knock that yellow in. I think he's certainly going to try it. He's going to try something here. Just like that. I think he's all right there, you know.
I think he is, but that was a bit of an unfortunate little kiss, really, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Just for some hampered queuing.
But just having said that, yeah, he's got to mind his work here, because really George has got four drop-ins here if he does get to the table. So Jamie's got to be really careful here.
Where's he gone with that? I'm not sure that that's the best shot I've ever seen Jamie play.
No. I mean, don't get me wrong, the clearance was horrible anyway, but... Oh, he's played that like a dream.
That's a good shot. Has he got an... Oh, he's just gone a bit far.
Again.
He could have done with being around about the bulk line there, couldn't he? Give himself an angle just to swing around for the other red.
See, Jamie's got absolutely nowhere to hide here. Either he's got no safety shot on. He's got no snooker. This is just all-out attack, this finish.
Pretty standard for Jamie.
See, I didn't like that because I think this yellow cuts into the middle quite comfortably and he's just got drop-ins again. I looked at this shot earlier and I thought there's nowhere where he can leave the white.
No.
Having said that, George may miss it. But it's there. It's comfortably there. And this is what I was talking about. Any mistake from Jamie there, just...
Yeah,
he had rollings, basically.
Easy finishes.
So this should be a... Should be 8-6.
Evening, Jason Shaw. Isn't it funny how when somebody that's got a big name... says something entertaining.
Oh, they just get loads of likes.
There's millions of likes that all of a sudden pop up. I mean, okay, but it's only five now.
If Joe Bloggs would have said it, nobody would have liked it. It must be because you're such a nice guy, Jason.
And Bernard, the score is on the screen for you.
See, Rob Chilton's just doing a crying face. I bet he gets a like on it.
Yeah, he is, look, because...
I'm going to do it.
Oh, yeah. Hello, Rob Chilton. How are you?
People are so harsh, aren't they? Terrible cut, middle game is over. Both shouldn't be playing for a fiver.
I think Jason Shaw missed these two next balls.
Hold on. Check out all the likes coming for Jason's next comment.
I'll tell you what. Do you know what?
Do you think he played to cover the black?
No. He's played it, in my eyes. He was putting lots of side on it to get on the black nicely. Didn't need to at all.
Could have just dropped it in.
He's missed the pot purely for putting side on it.
Yep. Absolutely no need.
Well. Well, Jamie's had an absolute shocker there.
Has he, or has he just left him to have to get the black out?
Why have you just fouled?
Fouled. Didn't realise nothing hit. Sorry, I wasn't watching properly.
Why have you just fouled? What? Just, wow.
Ouch. Evening, Mark Bailey. Nice to see you watching.
Well, you've just got to put that down. I mean, I don't even know what he's played. Well, I mean,
look, just put
this.
The black save.
What is going on here today? Yeah, he's just put the black save.
Or has he? I think it might be slightly off the cushion, actually. So, Galloway giving George some grief here.
Yeah.
Which is funny, because they're actually mates.
Well.
But I suppose.
They were giving each other some yesterday. God.
Yeah.
It was a...
This is going beyond the red.
It's
going beyond the red.
Oh, my word. He's not. That's painful. That's really painful. Sorry about the cursing in the background.
Well, it is like league ball indeed. Mind you, I don't think you've ever been to Banbury. Come and watch that league sometime. I'll tell you what.
So. That is about the best that you could possibly have hoped for.
Yeah, but even so, Simo doesn't miss these.
No. Wow, straight back where it was.
I'll tell you
and with some more awkward going now. Oh. He's going to have to stir up a bit of mustard here.
Well. Oh, my God.
You couldn't have written that, could you?
Sorry, how many people have you got watching this?
Let's have a look. 1,500 okay. Just on Facebook.
I'm apologising right now to the 1,500 viewers that are watching this.
Ouch.
Whatever you say about our stream and commentary, this match isn't our fault. Okay? I just want to put it out there right now. This isn't our fault. And I am so, so sorry. If we were charging for this, I would be personally reimbursing you all.
So, David Eaton, we've got the real money match coming a little bit later on. These two are just a sideshow act.
This is getting a little bit louder here. Emma Sanders is loving it, obviously. It's, I'll tell you what, this could actually turn into the Dan O'Rourke and Mary Cunningham game.
It's not far off, is it, at the moment, really? Oh, no, actually, there's been a break dish. So, oh, there was one actually in that match as well, actually. Let's have a look. What have we got? What have we got? What balls are we going, Jakes?
What are we going? We are going... You have got...
I reckon reds.
I'd say you've got to go reds. You absolutely have to.
Play this one into the corner. Get onto the one on the cushion. Get that out of the way.
With yellows, you see, you've got one on the rail. You've got one tucked behind that red, which is unpottable. So reds all day long.
I tell you what, or even screw back onto the cushion. Play the one into the. Yeah. Oh, he's absolutely perfect.
Well,
play this into the corner pocket. Then take the one on, if he's got enough wiggle maneuver.
Wiggle maneuver.
Wiggle room. Wiggle
sorry,
room.
What planet have you just stepped on from?
Yep. Apologies for that. Look, we all know Dan O'Rourke's useless. He's that useless, he isn't even here.
Yeah, who's dragging who down indeed? Well, I can't believe what I saw last frame. That was like watching me and Reggie.
Yeah.
It wasn't far off.
It was. I don't want to think about that game anymore.
No,
that was painful.
Nor do I. I lost too much money. So, he's just come the wrong side, that. It needs to be another... Sorry,
just getting off of drinks.
Mr. Duffy, getting us our drinks. Thank you, sir. Again, he's just lost the white there. So he's going to have to play a similar sort of shot again, but this time with a little bit more side. Get the white coming down past the right middle bag towards the red. Just there, that looks absolutely perfect. That is a great shot.
That is a great shot.
Absolutely bang on.
So, is this going to be George's first reverse dish? He's played that well.
See, that just goes to show what Matt Yorkins knows.
So, have a look at some stats. George's had two dry breaks, one reverse dish. There's a few things there for you to have a look at on screen. That was a nice little finish.
George pulls it back to within one frame. Certainly, standard was a little bit better there.
And the spirited champion of Terry Rogers is sacked now. Fucking
so imagine what Craig Marsh would do to both these players. Well, unfortunately, he didn't do anything to Simo apart from give him a
exactly
match.
Yeah.
And that
it's almost like saying, imagine what Gallo would be like when he's drunk.
Yes, George! Yes, George! Yes, yes, George! Yes, George!
So yellows will be the choice. Wonder whether they'll just try and pop to the middle here and come round and just disturb these two yellows that are next to each other, because they don't strike plant into that corner, so he needs to do something with them. So yeah, I think he's going to take it into the middle, run around, and he's going to get no luck at all, really. But he's got a long yellow. He certainly won't be taking this plant to the middle, but he'll take the long yellow. All he's got to do is cue it. It's actually a fairly straightforward shot.
Yeah, he's cued it well.
Conlon Jakob, does he finish?
Well, yeah, he should do. He's not really got a great deal of work to do, has he? Drop onto the bottom yellow first after this one.
Yeah.
He's covered it. Top then. So we're almost getting rejoined by Elizabeth. She's come to tidy up about after us. It's almost like it's just woman's nature. Might be getting cursed at. I'm getting told I'm supposed to be the good one. Shouldn't be taking the mickey.
Now,
Jamie's only got to get a nice, should be fairly simple skill shot at some point here. Mark Wilson. No. Yeah. You are more than welcome to go and watch X Factor if you really want to, pal. Some safety play from Jamie Simmons. That's unusual. Lakin, I don't think he's still on his strict diet. He's just decided to buy bigger clothes instead. And that is a shot and a visit to Jamie. Hopefully we won't have any issues with the music in the background. It's quite a difficult one when you're streaming a money match because you want a bit of music on. It makes the game a bit better for the players. Less sterile atmosphere, but unfortunately we get issues with copyright. And Sony have got their digs in, trying to make sure that nobody listens to their music without paying for it. Yeah, Mark Richardson, safety play really is unusual for Jamie. He's normally swinging the white ball off 18 cushions to get balls out rather than playing safe if he can. Seems to be having a good look at these in his own little way. See what he can produce. He's obviously confident in getting on the ball on the rail. It looks a bit too, potentially a bit too close to the cushion to be playing the double. Let's have a look from overhead. Yeah, it's a back double. Could probably get away with it.
Yeah, I know Mark Richardson. Unfortunately, Sony quite often block the stream from a few countries, and also on Facebook they block it entirely. So I'm really hoping we don't get chucked off at any point, because it would be a shame for part of this match to not be on the stream, as I think it might get both players quite a few more money match offers. So he's left himself on the back double. Clearly goes. That's a great shot from Simo. And he's regained that two-frame lead. He's got to be happier now. George really should have finished those balls earlier. That is 9-7 to Jamie Simmons. If you take away George's start, that's actually 9-5. At the moment, it's looking very much like the start was fair. Much to the contrary of what George has been saying all over Facebook for the last however long. Well, since the beginning of the week at least. Well, he nearly made a ball. Yeah, that is Galloway shouting. I'm not sure if it's shouting. It's more of a like aggressive roaring. Joy bait from Jamie.
Can we have an action replay on that, Yak?
Yeah, we can. Give me 2 seconds.
If the refs missed it, we will get a replay on it. Jamie's saying that the red moved. Can't really see it from there.
So we've had a look on stream. Didn't look like the ball moved.
But at the end of the day, the ref hasn't called it. It's not up to us to be the VAR. So yeah, a bit of controversy there in that frame. Jamie thought he'd move the red. George was adamant he didn't, and the ref didn't see it. So. Difficult to see it from where we were. Casey Singh thinks the red moved. Casey's probably just on a wind up. Know what he's like.
Check that. Jamie, check that. They did check it. It's too far away. You can't see it. It's queuing right over it. I can't see it. I won't call it. Move out our thing.
Shot's gone now. It's gone.
The ref is on the phone, actually.
The ref is on Tinder, but he's home. Yeah, I'll bring a few 6-year-old youngers,
mate. So this is all getting a bit vocal here in the background. I think the ref needs. The ref needs to concentrate on the game here rather than arguing with the crowd. We knew it would get like this at some point. Nice good shot from George.
So, I've just had a look at the replay.
And we've zoomed right in.
Zoomed right in, and it was not a foul.
Can we just have a look at that again?
Sure.
Can we zoom in any further, Jakob, or not?
Just to...
I've got a feeling it's probably the feather with the Q across the red.
So, hold on.
Can we zoom in any further?
Yeah, we can. Just give me a minute.
Sorry, folks. We're just looking at this rather than the game for a moment. Go on, right in, Jakob, if you can.
Let's have a look. Right. Hold on. I'll tell you what, I'll make it live. So.
You can judge for your...
That red did not move. That red 100% did not move.
No, I couldn't see anything.
No, and we were very close then.
I don't know whether anybody at home just watched that. No foul, I agree, Liam, actually.
Definitely not a foul.
No.
No, no. I don't think it's kicking off.
So things have quieted down. A little bit. Yeah, no foul. We didn't see anything. We certainly didn't see anything. That's
Gareth Slater's, it did not move. You could, from the replay then, you could have actually had your face nearly right up to the shot.
Tell you what a shot that is.
A hell of a shot that is.
What a shot that is from Simo. That's the difference. That's why they call him Satnav. It's about time he played a decent shot, to be fair.
Yeah.
Now here we go, there's a bit more satellite navigation coming here.
Can't believe someone just asked what the score is. What is it with these people?
Round four cushions.
Oh, look at this.
Or just the three.
Now we're getting treated to some actual pool. Can't tell, the camera wasn't close enough, come on. Have a word with yourself.
We did what we could, you know.
That's
we're
a
not
great
a
little clearance there from Simo, come on.
We did what we could with the action replay and the zooming in, you know, we're not the CIA. No, it's 10-7.
And unfortunately, we were inside a building, so I couldn't call up my mate at NASA to get us the satellite in.
All right, 10-7 to the Englishman. Oh, Gallo's never loved an Englishman so much in his life.
George to break. Let's have a look at some stats from Jamie here. So, Jamie Simmons, he's had two break dishes. He's had four dry breaks. There's a few things about Jamie there. Jamie started out life as a snooker player, often taking to the bays with his old man and making some big breaks at a young age. We asked Satnav where he currently resides and he said he gets about a bit. Usually takes a similar approach to getting home, mapping out the route to his next shot. which has meant relocating a few times.
And 13K is Simo's highest pot, which I find hard to believe, because this one's smashed that by over 25,000.
See, I thought he played Seb for more than that.
So did I, but... so what was the comment there about CIA? Scroll down one.
No, I can't on that because it's live.
All right.
Sorry, bud.
Oh, is that George's first foul break?
Yeah, it was. It was. Ten-seven. What have we got going on here? What balls is he going, Jenks?
Sorry, let's have a look. Where are we? I think he goes yellows.
Well, that's a great plant.
And now he takes yellows.
Yeah.
The only slight problem ball of his is the one in the top right-hand corner, which is behind the red, but obviously he's got to get tight on the cushion for that ball off the one in the other corner. So, and he will try and get on it.
From this shot, I think.
From this shot, maybe.
Yeah, that's a very well played shot.
Nice shot, mate. So, just got to... it's going to screw out of there, I would say.
Oh, no.
Oh, he's played it, played it well. A couple of ways of playing that. So, does Simo start getting in a bit of a flow? Just one shot, absolutely nothing to do with the cue, just stun it. We'll just roll it through a couple of inches, but nothing... there you go. And that is 11-7.
Bit of stunning like Elizabeth.
You've got a problem.
What a naff sense of humour.
Well, and that.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, that is 11-7.
I think by...
taking a four-frame lead, and that's actually a six-frame lead if you take off the two starts.
I think by 8 o'clock in the morning, I think Liz will have probably called the police on you. Or me. Or George.
I think the second one's probably more likely.
Yeah, definitely. The amount of times I've had women call the police on me.
Bobby Hanley, the stream is absolutely fine here, so hopefully it's absolutely fine everywhere else.
A couple of other people have said that. It must be their internet connection.
Yeah, definitely.
Somebody said it probably about half an hour ago, but we haven't seen anything.
Internet connection here is great, so it shouldn't be a drama at any point.
Anyway, I hope you're all enjoying the stream better than the pool.
That is Jamie Simmons to break.
Yeah, has had some good moments, to be fair. It's... it's a safe white, that's a without a doubt.
Or is it?
It's a safe white.
What a break, that's a lovely break. No, Simmons didn't have a two start. It was actually George that had a two start.
Right, one problem yellow.
Yeah.
He has to take yellows. One problem yellow.
Unless, of course, at some point his sat-nav can reroute to get the black out of the way of that pocket.
I think he'll probably end up, you know... he'll probably end up just dislodging the yellow off the ball to the middle, come off the cushion.
Tierney's only a hacker. Well, it looks like he hacked into Primark's shopping interface and got himself sent a whole host of random clothes.
It is pretty mix and match, isn't it?
Yeah.
Paul Anderson, what a guy.
The game has got a bit better in the last 30 minutes.
You mean the last two frames?
Well, that's about 30 minutes, isn't it?
Well, yeah, I suppose. It has been watching, like, you know, it's been like watching Keith Brewer and Stacey Vine.
What, both on ketamine or something?
No, well, yeah.
Sorry for the reference there.
Come on, Jamie!
You're worse than me.
But it's definitely like they've had some form of tranquilizer.
I've actually... both look like horses.
Ouch, that's gonna hurt.
Yeah, I'm not being funny. Any angle but that, it is absolutely frightening, isn't it? Any angle but that. So, George will just get his awkward red down the rail here. And, well, talk about party with confidence.
Yeah, it's a great shot. Evening, Graham Simpson.
Oh, Graham Simpson, Zippy. Top lad. Always got nice things to say. In fact, does he ever say a bad word about anybody?
No, I don't think so.
I've never heard. He's no, one of them,
oh,
isn't
ooh,
he?
Actually.
He's one of those creepily nice guys.
No. I think I've heard him say a few things every now and again.
What about me?
Adam Kirk.
Jakob's voice is amazing.
So,
I mean, where do people just get this constant drivel from?
No. See, the thing is, I got some messages from Adam Kirk.
Did
when
you?
When
what,
I was doing
sexy ones.
Pretty much, yeah.
Really?
Sort of. When I was doing the Murphy stream, he messaged me saying, "I don't know what it is, but your voice is so soothing."
Wow.
He actually asked me to record.
I would actually.
An audio book of Stephen Henry's new book.
Oh.
He said he'd pay me. I've said I'm sorry, but I just don't prostitute myself out.
Would you actually read me a bedtime story then one night? I think I could like this. I'd like that.
That's a little bit weird.
It's not that.
That's a great finish from George.
It wouldn't be that weird. I mean, I'm not talking about a children's book. I don't know, The Exorcist or something. You know. Could be any story. There was this girl who got possessed by a demon.
Called Jenks.
Yeah, sorry, Eric. It was getting a bit frisky there. Thank you, Adam Kirk.
Well, I think we left the iron on, actually.
Yeah, when I do the table next time, I'll do the back of George's head. Can't promise I wouldn't leave the iron on the back of his head too long and he'd end up looking like the singing detective, but... So he's made a ball off the break.
Yeah, look, this is funny. Right. For some reason...
Let's just hang on a sec. I'm just looking at this lay for a minute.
Evening, Luke Stoneham. Oh, Luke Stoneham. So.
I don't know what.
Luke Stoneham, he wants us to stream a match of his at the 147 Club in Swindon next Friday.
Ah, right, okay.
I did tell him I'd get back to him today about it, but unfortunately I've been just ever so slightly busy.
Right, and, okay. Well, Luke Stoneham, what, is he on the stream?
He's just come on and said hello.
Okay, Luke, how much are you playing for? Generally we take sort of around 50% of the pot. So, yeah, that'll be absolutely fine.
And in Jenks's case, about 50% of the room.
Hey,
sorry, Jenks.
That's fine.
I just think they need to clear a few more tables out.
Well. Yeah, I'm sure we could sort that out for you next Friday. I've got nothing better to do.
I'm going on holiday the next day.
Are you?
I am. That actually leaves you with the house to yourself. That's quite a freaky thought.
That is an amazing statement. I could invite a few of my Irish friends over.
I was about to say that I'll get Mum to come back, but I'm not sure I want that either.
That would be, yeah, unlucky.
So, Mum, stay away.
Yeah. You could come back on holiday, and I could be, hello, Jakob. I'm your new daddy. Make sure you're in tonight by midnight.
Well, at least I'd know where we've got the bald head from.
Well, there you go.
That's a nice pop from George.
Yeah, good shot from George, and he's bang on that red, is he?
Let's have a look. Hold on.
He would have loved to have been an inch more just so he can get comfortably on the red to the middle after this. But he's not sure he can see enough of it, you know.
I'd just like to point out at this stage, right, there are probably maybe 30 people in this room, and there are possibly 10 of them that are watching a game of snooker on another table instead of watching the pool match. I'm not sure what statement that is, but...
Oh, Paul Chucky Dunn's here as well.
Yeah.
One absolute gentleman he is. Hello, Richie Saunders. I see that Ross Dunham's name quite a lot on things.
Yeah, yeah. He likes to chuck a few quid at players every now and again.
All right, okay.
He backed, not entirely sure, but I think he backed Simo in the Simo v Seb game. He was definitely there.
Cool. I bet he was
pretty sure he had.
Twitching at the end.
Yeah, I bet. Not as much as Craig Blackford, who was twitching because he was having a fit after headbutting the table.
Good work. Typical Craig Blackford, really. I haven't seen Craig for a while, actually. So we used to have a few games here and there. Those are Matty Orcus's little references to you, by the way.
I've actually no idea what he's talking about.
I do.
Oh, well. He'll get over it.
That's a good shot from Simo. With the angle that he's, yeah, it's a good shot. You can see this. You can see this red to the bottom right-hand corner.
Blackie is a ledge. I will never forget that moment. Very funny.
That's a good shot. That just ensures that one more bag for that yellow is available.
So, peeps, if you like what you see, give the stream a share. I know there's already 1,200 people watching, but we could get it to more, couldn't we?
Just having a look at this. He's played that a couple of inches short, but it still shouldn't be an issue for him. Just, I think he's just got to come straight up and down with the white. And then take this yellow, which is next to the red, in the opposite corner. Now this should be a couple of straightforward shots for Simo. Just got to mind his work here. Just screwing back virtually, straight in between, aiming for right in between that red and yellow. Was he just going to come past it? Yeah. That's why I said in between, because then you don't, then that doesn't happen.
Yep. So, Ross Dunham's just said, I couldn't decide what to do, whether to celebrate with Simo or laugh at Blackie.
Well, his saving grace is he's pushed a ball safe. And it doesn't double because of the black. So, George has got to work this out. He's going to have to play the double in the bottom left-hand corner, but he's going to have to get on it somehow.
I've just realised why it is that everybody's watching the snooker. It's because Elizabeth's playing, and she's blatantly much better to watch than George and Jamie. Chucky's making the snooker look like it's child's play.
Jason Jason, on average, how much money do players put on themselves? I'll tell you what, Jason, it does completely depend whether they've got a job or not. And that's pretty much the brutal truth about it. There are quite a few money players who pretty much don't have a cent on themselves.
Now, the question is, George has won a few matches recently, so would you expect him to have a little bit on himself?
He's got
time?
A grand on himself.
Has he?
Yeah.
Good stuff. Nice to hear. Very good to hear. Well, he's left Timo a shot. And, I mean, that plant is imminent, isn't it? Even though he's snookered.
Yeah. No, he's... He didn't really want to push it there, but...
George hasn't necessarily got
the... He hasn't
the,
got a lot to go on again here.
No, George hasn't got an easy snooker here. He doesn't want to use this ball in the corner pocket too much because he'll end up putting that safe for himself, won't he?
So... Well, George has found it. You could say
that's
more luck than judgment, maybe, but at the end of the day...
Very nice.
It's the way you play the shot. You deserve a bit of running.
Is the pot of it?
Oh, and it... Wow.
Wow. Well, he's obviously gone for the pot there off the cushion, but...
Yeah, but...
He's just giving that frame away.
That's a terrible shot by Jamie, in my opinion. You should never be missing that. You've got so much scope. Even if you hit it, even if you overcompensate, you still hit it off the back cushion.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
For sure.
Yeah, that was a bad shot. But you never know what's going to go on in this match because we have seen some mistakes, I tell you, from very simple finishes.
Just a few. If anybody asks what the score is, I think they need their eyes testing.
See, I'll tell you what, that is not a good shot.
Well, I think he's got away with it.
He's got away with it. I don't think it was a very good shot at all.
No, it wasn't.
And that's 11-9. George needed that.
That is a 20 frames. We're going to have a break.
We're going to have a break for 10 minutes. And
we will stop the stream and restart it.
We will leave the...
So, if you all... So I'm just going to have a quick look, actually, to see how much time we've got left. Yeah, I'm going to cut the stream. We'll be back in a minute. We're going to restart it so we don't hit the four-hour limit on Facebook. And we'll be right back with you.